Good morning students, welcome to New Era Global School online teaching class. This is your Devi ma'am, science teacher. So, good morning everyone. Let's begin our class with the prayer. Each and everyone, stand in your place, join your hands and get ready for the prayer. Start. Okay, so join your hands and get ready for the prayer. Om Bhurbhuvah Svah Sattavitur Varenyam Bhargo Mejustahi Mahi Nido Yodana Prashodayat. Om Bhurbhuvah Svah Sattavitur Varenyam Bhargo Mejustahi Mahi Nido Prashodaya. Okay students, slowly open your eyes. So with the prayer, we will start our 7th chapter. So yesterday I have completed the 7th chapter and today we will revise the 7th chapter revision sheet. So each and everyone come to page number 28. Okay, page number 28. First one, write true or false for the following. What is the first one? You have to write true or false. What is the first one? Mangroves or the trees, they found in the desert regions. Is it right? No, it is a false. Mangroves are found on the swampy areas. So the statement is false. Come to the second one. Forest in hot and rainy areas, they have the deciduous trees. So hot and rainy areas, they are called as an evergreen trees. So the statement is said to be the false. Third one, mountain trees, they have the waxy needle-like leaves. Yes, obviously it has the waxy needle-like. The statement is said to be true. Then fourth one, mangroves grow in grasslands. Again it is said to be the false. Okay. Then come to the fifth one. The stem of many desert parks, including cacti, they are thick and fleshy and can store the water. Is the statement is right? Yes. The stem of many desert plants, they have the cacti, thick and fleshy and they store the water. So the statement is said to be true. Come to the second one. Give two examples for the following. Okay, you have to give the two examples for the following. First one, give two examples for desert animals. I am not talking about the desert plants, animals. So, scorpions and camel. Okay, these are all the two examples. Second one, give two examples for the evergreen trees. Evergreen trees ka example, ebony and rubber. And third one, give two examples for the deciduous trees. So deciduous trees ka example, gulmohar and sal. These are all the two examples. Fourth one, mountain trees. What are the example of mountain trees? Pine and fir. And then fifth one, floating aquatic plants. What are the examples of the floating aquatic plants? It is water hyacinth, and Duckweed. Now mark the answer, students. I am repeating again. First one, true or false? It is then false. Second one, false. Third one, true. Fourth one, false. Fifth one, true. And give two example. First one, scorpion and camel. Second one, ebony and rubber. Third one, bullmonger sun. Fourth one, pine and fir. Last one, water hyacinth and duckweed. Okay. Now, come to the next one. That is a match the following. So, third one is said to be the match. What is the first one? Mangroves. So, where the mangroves will grow? Mainly in the swamp regions. Mark the option D. First one, co-option D, swamps. Second one, coconut. Where the coconut will grow? Mainly in the coastal areas. That is option number 5. Third one, tape grass. Tape grass is an example of underwater plant. That is an option number A. And then fourth one, acacia. So acacia is a gum. It is a gum plant. And then fifth one, it is called as an eucalyptus. Eucalyptus, it is a medicine plant. Eucalyptus is a medicine plant. Okay. So mangroves, it grows in swamp regions. Coconut in the coastal areas. Tape grass is an underwater plant. Acacia is a gum. And eucalyptus is a medicine. Okay. Now come to the next one. Right. One word for the following. Okay, you have to write the one word for the following. Plants that grow on land. As we discussed yesterday, the plants grow on lands. They are called as terrestrial plants. The plants that grow on land. They are called as terrestrial plants. Second one. Plants having the leaves that remain green almost all year. Almost all year means it is called as an evergreen trees. Third one, plants that grow under the water surface, that grow under the water. What are they? They are called as an underwater plants. Okay, underwater plants. Then fourth one, what is the fourth one? Plants that trap insects inside them. They are called insectivorous plants. What are they? They are called insectivorous plants. Fifth one, plants that absorb nutrients from dead plants and animals. So, they from dead plants and animals, they are called as an parasitic plants. What are they? They cannot absorb the nutrients from the soil. Okay, sorry. They are called as an saprophytic plants. Okay, saprophytic plants. The plants that get the food. Yesterday I didn't discuss this chapter. So, saprophytic means which eat only the dead decaying matter. Okay, dead plants and the dead animals. From that, they will get the nutrients. They are called as the saprophytic plants. Okay, students. Now, come to the fifth one. What is the fifth one? It is a logical questions. So, fifth one, it is said to be a logical questions. See the first one. What is the first one? Roots are parts of the plant that grow below the ground. Can you think of the place where the roots grow above the ground? So this is the logical question. You have to think and then answer. Almost all the plants, they have the roots in the underground. But some of the plants, the roots will come outside. What is the name of the plant? So the name of the plant, you know,
It is called as a mangrove plants. Okay, they are called as a mangroves.
Okay, what happened? They do not, the soil does not have the...
So, answer is, these plants grow in marshy areas. Okay, they grow in the marshy areas. The soil is filled with water. Okay, filled with water.
Then, that does not contain,
it does not contain enough air. Okay, they do not contain the enough air.
Okay, so what will happen? The root.
Okay, enough air. So, the root will come.
The root will come.
The root will stick out of water to get the air. It is called breathing roots. So this much answer you have to write, students. Okay.
So while writing, I'm telling that answer again. Question: root are the parts of the plant that grow below the ground. Can you think of the place where the roots grow in the ground? So, mainly in the Sundarban areas.
So, in Sundarban and West Bengal, these areas are found. Mangroves are found. So, the answer is mangroves. These plants grow in the marshy areas where the soil is filled with the water. It does not contain the enough air.
So the root will stick out of water to get the air. So it is called as a breathing roots. In Sundarbans and the West Bengal, we can see the mangrove trees. Okay, students, copy it in your revision sheet. Then come to the next one. Okay, come to the next one. Why does the leaf of the lotus plant not root in the soil, so not root in water? Okay, so I'm writing the answer here
for the second one. Lotus plant, they will not, the root will not be rooted.
Why? Because I'm writing the answer, just write it fast.
Lotus plants have large plate-like leaves. Okay, they have the large plate-like leaves that float on the water surface. Okay, that float on the water surface. So, the leaves have a waxy coating. They have the waxy coating to protect from rotting.
Okay, students. So this was the answer for that. Now third one. Third one is a homework for you. Okay, third one is a homework for you. Try to write it by yourself, or otherwise I will send you the PDF. Okay.
Now, come to the next one.
It is a less recall. Simple one.
Type of plants. So, type of plants. What is the first one? Aquatic plants. Write three aquatic plants. First one is said to be the floating plant. Second one is called as a fixed plant. Floating plants, fixed plants, and next one it is called as a submerged plant. Okay, then insectivorous plants. Insectivorous plants, and next one it is said to be a terrestrial plant. ओके सेंसिव इंसेक्टिवरस का सैप्रोफाइटिक एंड पैरासाइटिक, टेरेस्ट्रियल का इन फर्स्ट डैश राइट माउंटेन प्लांट माउंटेन फॉरेस्ट एंड ग्रासलैंड्स एंड सेकेंड यू हैव टू राइट डेजर्ट स्वैम्प एंड मार्शी एरियाज ओके रिपीटिंग अगेन लिसन लेट्स रिकॉल
देयर इज अ क्विक रिकैप ऑफ दिस चैप्टर टाइप ऑफ द प्लांट्स थ्री टाइप्स आर देयर aquatic plants insectivorous plants terrestrial plants aquatic plants floating plants fixed plants and submerged plants insectivorous ka you can write saprophytic and parasitic and terrestrial plants forest mountain and grasslands and then desert swamps and marshy areas so these are all the type of the plants let's recall then come to the next one reproduction in animals sorry Come to the next page, page number 13, picture-based questions. So many unusual plants, you have to write only the name of the plant. What is the first question? Insectivorous plants.
Come to the picture-based question. In picture-based question, what are insectivorous plants? Okay, write the answer for that one. The leaves of some plants the leaves of some plants are modified to trap the insects okay the leaves of some plants are modified to trap the insects so they are called
sorry modified to trap the insects
So, modified to trap the insects, so they get nutrients from the insects. So they are called insectivorous plants. Okay. Then come to the next one.
Name the insectivorous plants present here.
First one is said to be the Venus flytrap. Second one is called as a pitcher plant. Then third one that is a grass and you have to learn and then give your answer.
Okay, students. So this is up to you. 7th chapter and tomorrow we will discuss you about the 8th chapter okay students see you tomorrow